Hi, and welcome to this demo video of the Texture Cloud Transformation Platform for System Integrators. My name is Lucas, and I work as a partner manager here at Texture. And today, I'm going to give you a brief insight into how our platform works and how it can support your projects. But first, a quick introduction of us. So Texture is located in the heart of the Alps in Innsbruck, Austria, and we are a software company with a partner focus, delivering an end-to-end cloud transformation platform that supports assessment, migration, and continuous modernization projects. And by working in one tool, you have one central data hub where communication can flow both within your team, but also to create transparency internally in your organization or externally to the end client. And our cutting-edge transformation tool helps you as a system integrator to deliver high-quality projects with speed through intelligent recommendation and process standardization. And this is what we are all about. We want to support you in helping your client to get the best value out of your project as possible. So let's just jump into it and see what it looks like live. And this is what the user interface looks like. So the platform is a SaaS application that runs agentless in your web browser. So you can collaborate throughout your team, wherever you are on a global scale, even if the team is scattered all around the world, which makes it really easy to use. So one of the first things that we see when we come into the Texture platform is what we can see up here. It's the dashboard. And the dashboard is created to create communication and transparency. We've seen that one of the main challenges that a lot of assessment and delivery teams has is to keep everyone in the loop, to make everyone understand and see what is the progress of the project, what are the outcomes, and where are we standing with the status quo at the moment. So we have built in very strong communication capabilities within Texture. One of these are the dashboard that is based on reports. So from the data that you feed into Texture, you can create different reportings and put them here on the dashboard and customize your dashboard to your need. So okay, we had a look at the dashboard. Let's move to the centerpiece of the Texture platform, which we call the Transformation Cockpit. So the Transformation Cockpit allows you to streamline your assessment, to generate architectures for your IT landscape, and to do forecastings. And it's divided into four different parts, from discovery, assessment, target architecturing, and road mapping. Before we look into these four phases or parts of the transformation cockpit, let's set up some preferences for the target architectures. So of course, on a strategic level, your clients might want different things, and this can be set up here in Texture really easily. So let's just play around with the fictitious client who needs or wants to run a PaaS replatforming on either GCP, Azure, or AWS, and they want it to land or be somewhere in the European Union. Then this is how you would set that up. So the first phase of the transformation cockpit we call discovery. This is where teams are starting to collect data on applications. Generally, it is a challenge to get data on applications because it's scattered all over the place and might be found in different places. Historically, this has been made through Excel surveys, and we've tried to really streamline this to make it easier for you to find the data and collect the data. So through arbitrary sources, you can feed in data in different ways into Texture, through vendor-specific ways, manually, or through our built-in service capabilities. All of this then gathered into one single repository to get a good overview of the data that you have collected throughout your team. In this way, your teams get an overview of the data you gathered about your applications and their data completeness according to the assessment rules at any point. You can get an overview of all your applications, or you can choose to look into a specific application to get more details. In this example, we use the Business Relationship Manager. In this application-specific view, we get some details on the application. We can see, for example, the general data completeness, data problems, and the mapping of the stack as is. So this supports you in knowing more about where data is needed and where data problems might occur. So from this view, you can send out then, for example, a survey, which allows you to collect more data from an application owner or whoever knows more about this application if data is missing. So it makes it very easy for you to collect more complementary data for the project. The next step is the assessment. And in the past, we've seen a lot of teams struggling with holistically assess each application, not just from a technical standpoint, but also from a business, security, and compliance point of view. In Texture, the application is the central piece, and through executing rules, each application gets a recommendation or holistic recommendations according to the 6R strategies. So by looking at this in the platform, we can get a general overview of the application sorted by timing, risk, cloud readiness, and cloud benefit. So the assessment is based on 4 categories of rules, and depending on what rules are active, the platform will ask you to collect different types of data, as we already discussed a little bit in the discovery phase. This makes it possible for you as a user to turn rules on and off depending on what the project requires, and also to assure that you collect the right data. If we again have a look at the application-specific assessment, we get a detailed view of the assessment on this application. So you can see here the data completeness, cloud readiness, cloud benefit, and migration risk scorings. Additionally, it suggests the 6R migration strategy for each application. And when we are then talking about projects that might contain hundreds and hundreds of these applications, one of the most labor-intense tasks is to figure out the optimal target architecture for each application and then to calculate the cost of these in the cloud. And this is where the target architecture really shines, which is the next step of the cockpit. Here you get an overview of what suggested target architecture has been generated for your applications. And this includes suggested providers, suggested services, and cost estimations of the target architectures. On a strategic level, these architectures are based on the preferences you have set for the project as shown earlier in this video. And the preferences are possible also to cover certification requirements for compliance, for example, preferred location, and much more. And based on what you have selected here, Texture will only show you the target architectures that comply with your preferences, which helps you to make important decisions for your client and for the project in its whole. And here you can also see the specific application displaying cost, cloud products, and a deeper explanation of the proposal for the specific application. So, for example, on the price and billing of material, you can get an even more detailed price overview, and you can then also graph the stack to see what changes will occur when moving this application to the cloud, and also what needs to be done. So that this can then be showcased to both project groups and to the customer to adjust the target architecture and make a final decision for the project. And with that, we have landed in the 4th part of the cockpit, which is road mapping, where you can create migration waves and create a plan for the project moving forward. So to wrap this video up, I just want to show you real quick the other parts of the platform. Let's start with the structure, which is the underlying data model of Texture that has its foundation in the application, as already mentioned before. You also have the repository that collects all the data, where you can just search and look into what kind of data have you fed in there. You have the admin panel, where you do all the administrative stuff like create importers, import data, make adjustments to surveys, and add people and users into the platform. And you have a documentation up here that also supports you with documents, how-tos, and other things that you might need when using the tool. So with this, I just want to say thank you so much for listening, and I hope that this video gave you a good insight, first insight into the tool. If you want more deep knowledge, look into our deep dive videos, and if you also want to read more, you find some readings in the description below or on our website, texture.io. And we really hope to hear from you, so don't hesitate to reach out to us if you have any questions or if you want to know more about what we can do for you. Thank you so much for listening. Bye.